السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Our speaker today is Maulana Yusuf Suleiman, who is currently a teacher at Madrasa Rahmania and has previously been with Radio 1584. His topic today is the importance of the month of Zulhijjah.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. يقول الله تبارك وتعالى في كلامه المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن أولى الناس بإبراهيم للذين اتبعوه وهذا النبي والله ولي الذين آمنوا صدق الله العظيم. Honorable listeners, brothers in Islam, I greet you in a greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It is just the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah has given us Islam. Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, when they thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they used to say, Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana lihada wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. And it's also a verse of Quran. That all praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has guided us to this deen. That had it not been of Allah, we were not going to be guided. Respected brothers in Islam, every month of Islam has got an event behind it. Just as we are witnessing this month of Dhul-Hijjah coming to an end, in the same way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also will make us to see our very same end also. And how fast the year has gone. So this month of Dhul-Hijjah is got to do with the life of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Yea, in the ayah of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that very among mankind who have the best claim to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam are those who follow him and this prophet, meaning Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam, and those who believed, and Allah is the protector, friend of those who believe. If you look at the life of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, how much of sacrifice he has given to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how much of difficulty he had to adhere to in order that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes him his friend, his khalil. The title of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam being Khalilullah, it was not just received like that. There was a lot of sacrifices behind it. And that is why our deen also, Islam also, it is a religion of mujahada, sacrifice. And we are such a nation that if we do not give sacrifice, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes sacrifice from us forcefully. If we do not sacrifice that which we love most, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes it away from us forcefully. What do we understand by this? Somebody may say, Allah takes it forcefully from us. Does that mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the oppressor? And a'udhu billah, Allah forbid. Allah is not like that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one whom he loves most. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put that person into most of tribes. That is why we hear, أَشَدُّ النَّاسَ بَلَاءً الْأَنْبِيَاء ثُمَّ الْأَمْثَالِ فَالْأَمْثَالِ. That most people who are tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the prophets and the like of them, and those who are the like of them also. So when you are a believer in this world, you cannot just say, I brought iman, I am a believer, and that's all, and then you sit and recline. Test will come in your way. Let's just take the word, the meaning of the word mujahada itself. Mujahada, mim, jim, alif, ha, da. Right? These letters, they have the meaning behind them. Mujahada, first of all, means wealth. Right? Jim, jism, your body. And alif, awqat, your times. And ha, hijrah, migration. And dal, da'wah. When you have this, understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبْلَنَا. Those who strive in our deen, in whichever way you can think of, provided it does not compromise the injunctions of Sharia which are given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Provided that does not violate the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inviting mankind towards the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those who understood it, people like Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, Rabi bin Bishr radiallahu anhu, when he went to the emperor and he asked him, what was the reason of coming here to us? لِمَا جِئْتُمْ هِنَا قَالْ إِبْتَعَثَنَا اللَّهُ. Allah has sent us لِنُخْرِجَ الْعِبَادِ مِنْ عِبَادَةِ الْعِبَادِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّ الْعِبَادِ وَمِنْ دِيكِ الدُّنْيَا إِلَىٰ وُسْعَتِهَا وَمِنْ جَوْرِ الْأَدْيَانِ إِلَىٰ عَدْلِ الْإِسْلَامِ. That Allah has sent us to take mankind out of the slavery of mankind towards the slavery of Almighty Allah. And to the from out of the corruption and oppression of other creeds and beliefs towards the belief of Islam, which is monotheism. And because we're speaking about this sacrifices of Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, and we are supposed, and we are, those who claim that we follow the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, those who follow the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and hence Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the one who followed the millat of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. There was a person by the name of Zayd bin Amr, who is to live amongst the Quraysh. He was a Quraysh also. One day he met Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a place called Balda. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam presented food to him. And he said, I cannot eat your food. Because you Quraysh, when you slaughter, you take the name of other than Allah. And therefore I will not partake of your food. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left him when the man did not want to eat. And he parted from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now let us just understand this little line, that I will not take your food. We as the reciters of Kalima La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, how much of our times do we give to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How much of sacrifice to you are we ready to give for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This person was not a mushrik, but was those amongst those people who only believed, were on who only believed in Allah as one. But they were not following any creed. They were not following any religion or a divine revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he said, I will not take your food. And he went out of Makkah al-Mukarramah and he came to a place called Sha'a, which is today Syria, Palestine, Iraq, Iran, Lebanon, all those places. And he met a Jewish rabbi. And he asked him, I want to come into your religion. So the Jewish rabbi told him, there's no way for you, right, that you can come into our religion and become like us, except if you are ready to take the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you, then you can become a Jew. He says, this was the very same reason that made me to leave Makkah al-Mukarramah, because I do not want to associate myself with those who have incurred the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon them. So he left. I mean, before that, they had a small discussion and he told him, what do you think? Where can you refer me to? He says, I do not know of any other religion except Hanif. Now, Millata Abikum Ibrahim, the deen of your forefather Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was the upright deen, and that is the deen called Hanifa. The upright deen that is called Hanifa, and that is the deen of Islam, which teaches the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyway, he left, he met a Christian scholar, and he asked him, he wants to become a Christian. And the Christian scholar also told him that if you want to be in our religion, you have to obey and be ready to accept the la'anat, the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. He says, I cannot do that. But is there any other religion that you can recommend it to me that I may follow? He said, well, if then you are ready for that, then they say millat, which is called Hanif, that you have to follow. And like this man came back to Makkah al-Mukarramah, Asma bint Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anha. She says that I saw this Tufail bin Amr, Zayd bin Amr, he was standing with his back against Kaaba, lifting his hand and says, by Allah, I am the one who claimed, I am the one who is following the upright religion, because I do not believe in idols. Now, honorable listeners, in our hearts, to be honest with our own self, how much of idols are hidden in us? How much of idols, how much of ghayrullah do we believe in it? How much of things do we attribute it to ghayrullah? It is said in the day of Qiyamah, Jahannam will be taking revenge on every person. And Jahannam will address every person that akalta min rizqillah, you have eaten from the source sustenance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa abadta li ghayrihi, and you worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just for a moment, when in our own lives we say to ourselves that sustenance is from Allah. Allah, you are the provider. Allah, you are everything. And what is the meaning of Rabb? It is said Rabb means that thing, when a person is in difficulty, that what comes to your mind first thing, that is your Rabb. When we are in difficulty, do we go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask from Allah first? Or do we turn to means and other things? To adopt means is not haram. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was the most muttaqi, that one who feared Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most. But when he went into the battlefield, he put his armor on. And then, Bismillahi tawakkaltu ala Allah. So we also, when we march out, when before we can call the doctor, we ask Allah, you give me the shifa, because you are Shafi. Then call the doctor. It's just the changing of things. And this month also, honorable listeners, it is a month which is associated to the martyrdom of Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu. We know Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, what type of Sahabi he was, that the Malaika of Rahman, they were also feeling, they had modesty. They could not just approach Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu in any way. Istaha minhum al-Malaika. The angels they had, they felt shame in front of Uthman radiallahu anhu. Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu was known as Dun Nurayn, that one of two lights, because he married the two daughters of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him this. He prophesied that Uthman, you will be assassinated. And in this month of Dhul Hijjah, Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu was imprisoned in his own house, house arrest if we may call it. For days, no food. Until Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu came to him and he brought some water and he threw the water, he wanted to pass, but the rebels could not allow him to reach Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu anhu. Anyway, Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, last thing that he did, he was just to wrap his amama, turban, and he threw it over the wall just to show Uthman radiallahu anhu that I was there for your rescue. When these people, the servants of a Shia person called Abdullah bin Sabah, he was a Jewish person who claimed to be a Muslim from Yemen. He came to Medina Munawwara and he had his group. And the same people, they denied Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu for drinking from that the well which he purchased when in Medina Munawwara there was no fresh water. The same Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu who equipped the Muslim army. The same Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called him, that is there anyone who can purchase the land adjacent to the masjid so that the extension of masjid could be made? He took out this money. And he addressed them in this manner, that you remember that what I've done to you, today you do not even allow me to drink from that well which I bought, which I purchased with my own money. And this man of Dhul Hijjah witnessed that when the son-in-law of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was murdered while reciting Quran, they say the stains of blood is still there in the Quran. On the ayah, فَسَيَكْفِيكَهُمُ اللَّهُ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Allah will be sufficient for you, and He's the one who sees, who hears everything, and He knows everything. The Quran is still preserved in the museum of Top Kabi in Turkey. This were the people who understood the meaning of the ayat, إِنَّ أَوْلَى النَّاسِ بِإِبْرَهِيمُ. The people who are close to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, close to the sacrifices of Ibrahim alayhi salatu, لَلَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُ. They are those who follows him. وَهَذَا النَّبِي. And follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the lifestyle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That Nabi, I was reading a book written by Mufakir Abu Layth Samarkandi rahimahullah ta'ala. He narrates a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was telling people that even in Jahannam, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam will come and will see the Jahannamis, those unfortunate people that they will be doomed towards the fire. And when he comes there, he will see his ummah. And in that state, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam will plead with Allah that, Wallah, please let them come out of Jahannam. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when everyone, he will come out from his Jannah and he will come to Jahannam. And when the Malik, the doorkeeper of Jahannam, he will see the nur of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, And he will ask, who is here today in Jahannam? That his nur has illuminated Jahannam. He says that it is me, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and I came to intercede. I came to take out the people of Jahannam, the sinners of my ummah in this fire. So, respected brothers, Allah has made us Muslim. Allah has made us the followers of this Rasul of Allah. As I've said in the beginning of the talk, that we are the people of Mujahada, sacrifice. And I explain for those who came late, just the meaning of the word Mujahada. I said mim means mal, wealth. This wealth of ours, Allah has made us the guardian of it. We may call it ours, because if we do not use it in the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants, then we are going to be answerable for it. Then, secondly was the word jim in mujahada. It means our body. This body of ours here is an amanat. It is the trust which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. And alim means awqat, our time. Sayyidina Hassan Basri rahimahullah ta'ala says, I've met such people that they were ready to give everything of theirs but their time. Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum were such people that they could give you anything. That is why one person said, Sahaba spent and they became rich. And we are withholding and trying to fill our pockets, and we're becoming more poorer, poorer and poorer. So he says they would give you anything but their time, because they understood the value of time. That is why a great Imam, Imam Idris al-Shafi rahimahullah ta'ala, says it was sufficient for the guidance of mankind if only the surah wal-asr by the oath of time was revealed. And also hijrat. Hijrat, migration. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was made to leave his homeland and come into Makkah al-Mukarramah and leave all his friends and come to a desert, a place where he knew nobody, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes in life, we got to leave our beloved ones and go out and spread the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In whichever way, so long as you are saving one soul from the fire of Jahannam. And alhamdulillah, here, the brothers are doing a good work because they are caring for mankind. They institute services. So if we can link ourselves with those who are doing khair, good, inshallah we'll have a share in that also. And da'wat. Da'wat ila Allah, udu'u ila sabili rabbika bil hikmah. وَالْمَوْعِدَةُ الْحَسَنَةِ Invite towards the deen of Allah with polite speech, with hikmat, wisdom. You do not grab a man and say, I will kill you, become a Muslim. No, with wisdom. Allah has given us wisdom. That's why he says, اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ Fear Allah, Allah will teach you wisdom. وَآخِرَ دَعْوَنَا مِنْ حَمْدِ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ